The hearts of our children need our protection from rheumatic heart disease, or RHD. Without urgent action, 8,000 more will be affected over the next 11 years. 1,300 will need heart surgery, and 650 could die. We have to stop it, and now we can. 25 years of research and community wisdom has come together to create the Endgame Strategy. It's the blueprint to make RHD history. But we have to start now.
Kids as young as 2 years old are now being diagnosed with rheumatic heart disease. It is a totally preventable disease, and we have to end it.
The strategy identifies five priority areas that work together to end RHD. Priorities that will boost Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander leadership, community-based programs, healthy environments, early prevention, care and support for those already living with the disease.
There's no simple solution to a disease this tough. There's no single strategy that will work. We have to commit to doing it all to see the end of rheumatic heart disease.
At the core of all our work needs to be our communities. We need to empower and fund communities at high risk of RHD to develop their own culturally appropriate programs, to increase awareness of strep A, and how a sore throat or skin sores can lead to RHD, so that people can be diagnosed before RHD develops, to ensure access to culturally safe healthcare, develop peer support networks, and comprehensive follow-up care.
There's no simple fix and there's no quick fix. This is going to need ongoing government support if we're really going to get rid of this, and we need to focus on enabling, training, and supporting the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander workforce to be able to implement the strategies so that people can have access to the best quality care.
Next, we need an Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander-led group to oversee and coordinate Endgame implementation nationally.
94% of people who get rheumatic heart disease are our people, so it's really important that this group is led by our people.
This group would oversee funding to communities to prevent RHD and ensure the best treatment for those already living with the disease, work with governments to address the root environmental and social causes, deliver technical support, act as the critical link between researchers and communities, and monitor and review progress. Healthy houses and environments will stop RHD. We have to reduce overcrowding, repair homes, and ensure everyone has access to hygiene essentials, such as hot water, running showers, and washing machines. We need to stop sore throats and skin sores leading to RHD. That means tackling strep A infections through programs tailored by local people for local needs. New tools for health workers to diagnose and treat strep A infections, making it easier for people to have their skin sores and sore throats checked. Things like offering transport and flexible appointments. Importantly, we want the best quality of life possible for all people now living with acute rheumatic fever and RHD. We need to make sure the health system is culturally safe and easy to navigate. Fund regional coordinators to improve treatment in high-risk communities and ensure that mainstream services provide culturally safe treatment.
I believe that no child born today should die of rheumatic heart disease.
We now have the blueprint to end rheumatic heart disease for the next generation. Five priorities, 11 years of work. The end game starts now.
RHD needs to end because it's our children who are suffering the most.
By working together, we can make RHD history.